下面我再给大家介绍一下我们关于怎么降低它的 mortality。我也注意到世界上不同的国家，它的 mortality 事实上是有差异的。那么我们也看到德国它的 mortality 大概是 1.5%， 意大利它的 mortality 是 12%，现在 Bangladesh 它的 mortality 也是到了 10% 以上。 这里 mortality 高，其实不代表这边的医疗水平低。同样的，就像意大利跟德国，它 mortality 差这么远。据我跟这两个国家的医生的接触，还有我也了解到 Bangladesh 医生的水平，其实都是非常好的。那么 mortality 高与低，事实上取决于两个因素，也就是 mortality 里面，就是我们死亡的病例数跟总的病例数。所以在你个国家，如果我们 现在诊断的病例都是有症状的，那么都是重症的病人，它的整体上它的 mortality 就高。如果我们这个国家是扩大了检测，我们检测的量很大，而且对于很轻症的病人，甚至于密切接触者 close contacts 也进行检测，那你就会发现大量的病人。所以最近几天我也一直跟美国的专家，他的 public health 的专家，今天上午我还跟 UCLA 的公共卫生学院的院长，我们也在沟通，还跟 Yale 的教授也在沟通。我知道美国最近的检测量事实上是大幅度的上升，而且很多人如果是诊断为 COVID 的阳性，他还可以再领取整个联邦对他的一个补助。所以在这种情况下面，美国现在是扩大了一个检测。在这个基础上，我们也看到美国的 peak 已经到来了。 它的一个新增数字的一个峰值已经连续几天开始出现下降，所以在这种情况下面，如果你扩大你的检测，那你检测的病人当中就会有很多是轻症，甚至于是一个密接者无症状的，那你的 mortality 就会比较低。但是如果我现在不知道孟加拉的情况，孟加拉的情况如果是你检测的都是很重的人才进行检测，那么很显然你的 mortality 就会高。
And secondly, I would like to discuss the issue of how to lower mortality. Around the world, countries vary in their mortality rate caused by COVID-19. In Germany, it's about 1.5%. For Italy, 12%. And in Bangladesh, I noted that it's also over 10%. A high mortality doesn't mean that your healthcare capabilities are inadequate. I've talked to experts in all these countries, in Germany, Italy, and also in Bangladesh. The healthcare actually is quite strong and robust in all these places. I think here there are two things to consider. First is the total number of dead cases, the death toll. And second is the total number of infected cases. So if you only diagnose and treat those severe cases, then the result is that your mortality tends to be high. But if you expand the scale of testing, you test those close contacts, people with no symptoms or very mild symptoms, then you have a large base of infected patients, and this will lower your mortality. I've also been in close communication with experts in the US. This morning, I talked to doctors in UCLA and in Yale, and they've told me that in these days, the US has been rapidly increasing the coverage of testing. And for some COVID-19 positive patients, they could also even get subsidies from the government. So as a result of the rapid expansion of testing, the peak of infection in the US is around the corner. So in the next few days, well, actually at this moment, we are seeing a decline in the increase of new cases in the US. So if you have a large base of testing, you test those people with mild symptoms, asymptomatic patients, and people of close contacts, the mortality rate will be brought down. I do not know the situation in Bangladesh, but if you only test and treat those severe cases, and that will give you probably a higher mortality.
在上海到现在为止，我治疗了400个 local 的 case， 我治疗了接近200个 imported case。上海整体的 mortality 现在是 1%， 然后我们的同事在武汉，武汉的早期他的病死率 mortality 是 5%， 后期下降到 1.5%。 所以在这里我们还要讲到 mortality 影响的另外一个重要的因素，这个重要的因素就是说你的 medical resource， 你的 ventilator 是不是足够。在 local case 里面大概有 20% 的病人是 severe case， 他需要进行 oxygen 的治疗。如果这个时候这个区域出现的 outbreak， 你没有足够的床位数，那么就会碰到问题，或者没有足够的呼吸机，或者是无论是 invasive 的或者是 non-invasive 的，这些 ventilator 事实上都是非常重要的。所以在我们的病人当中，我们就必须有 20% 的床位数，所有的病人，有症状的病人，无症状的我们不去讲它，就是所有的有症状的病人当中 20% 他是需要氧气治疗。如果他们没有机会进行氧气治疗，这个重病人的加重到最后都跟死亡率有关系。那么在 20% 的里面有 15% 是不需要 invasive ventilator， 那么剩下来 5% 事实上需要是 invasive ventilator。 那么这个 5% 在所有的有症状病人当中的 5% 事实上需要 ICU 的床位。所以无论是武汉的早期或者是意大利的现在，事实上他们最后缺乏的都是 ICU 的床位。如果你能够提供充足的 ICU 的床位，像德国他就始终把自己的一个 mortality 维持在 1.5% 左右。所以氧气的治疗对于所有的病人我们认为是非常关键的。今天我也注意到这里有很多 有几位是孟加拉这里的临床大夫，临床的专家，所以我们无论你采取哪一种氧气的治疗，有一个要求，一定要把它的氧气的 saturation， 它的饱和度 SaO oxygen 或者 SP oxygen 维持在 92% to 96%， 一定要维持在这个水平。如果低于 92%， 事实上我们一定要 upgrade 我们的 oxygen therapy， 让它维持在这个区域。如果维持不了我们甚至会给他用 ECMO。 当然 ECMO 是他的一个治疗是非常昂贵，不一定就是没有条件也不一定非要给，但是这里的一个原则就是我们一定要有给予非常充分的 oxygen therapy。 在我们所有的有症状病人当中，我最后再重复一下 20% 有 5% 需要 invasive mechanical ventilator。Invasive mechanical ventilator 的数量就是决定于我们的 mortality。 如果我们这里的床位数跟 ventilator 是不够，我认为 mortality 一定会升高，所以这个也是我们现在治疗的最关键的一个点。
So, and here I would like to talk about the case in Shanghai. Here I've treated 400 local cases and 200 imported cases. The total mortality rate is around 1%. In the case of Wuhan, the mortality rate in the early stage is 5%, and later on it's been brought down to about 1.5%. So another important thing to consider for mortality rate is whether you have adequate medical resources. For example, enough ventilators. So in the case of Shanghai, among all the local cases, local infections, about 20% are severe cases which require oxygen therapy. So if if the region has an outbreak and it has no enough supply of beds or ventilators, or the equipment for either invasive or non-invasive oxygen therapies, ventilators, then this means that you could have a trouble. So among all the patients with symptoms that I've treated, 20% would require oxygen therapies. And if they do not have a proper oxygen therapy, the case, the situation could worsen and it could lead to death. So among these 20% of patients who need oxygen therapy, 15% would require non-invasive ventilation. The rest, 5%, would require invasive ventilation. In other words, they need ICU care. So in both Wuhan and Italy, the problem they had was that they do not have enough ICU beds to cover the needs. So in the case of Germany, they do have enough supply of ICU space. That is why they could keep the mortality rate at around 1.5%. So here I'd like to stress one principle. The oxygen therapy is critical for all patients with symptoms. I know that some of you are clinical practitioners, you are physicians at the front line. So I think it is important to provide oxygen saturation therapy to all patients, and the level of oxygen saturation should be within the range of 92 to 96%. It is very important to make sure that the level does not fall below the benchmark of 92%. Otherwise, it would be inadequate for the patient. You probably would need ECMO treatment, but that would be more costly and expensive to afford. So one principle I would like to underscore again here, oxygen therapy is really critical for all patients with symptoms. So in all cases I've treated, 20% are severe cases, 15% require non-invasive ventilators, 5% would require invasive or mechanical ventilation, in other words, ICU care. So if you can do this properly, you could reduce mortality rate. Otherwise, the mortality rate would be high.
关于再进一步降低 mortality 的一些策略, 我们还有要做的就是要对这些 mild case, 轻症的 mild case, 我们要 monitor。 因为有部分 mild cases, 它的 progress 速度会非常快。 对于 mild cases, 我们非常重要的治疗就是 nutrition, 营养的给予充分的营养是非常关键的。 然后在对它的一些 progression 的 indicate 进行监测, 包括 D-dimer, 包括 LDH, 这些数据的升高都是跟 最终的 mortality 有关系，所以对于轻症的病人，我们现在的经验是，他的 nutrition 是极为关键。到目前为止，我在这里再说一下，就是关于抗病毒治疗，我为什么把 support therapy 支持治疗放在 antiviral treatment 前面，最关键的一个原因就是因为现在所有的 antiviral treatment 通过现在 published 的 data， 我们没有充足的证据认为哪一种药物更加有效。包括前段时间我们 French colleagues 他们 published paper for hydroxychloroquine， 那么我们在中国做了 RCT 的研究，没有看到 hydroxychloroquine 在抗病毒方面具有特别好的优势，但是对 anti-inflammatory 方面，它是有一定的优势，所以我们现在没有办法用已有的抗病毒药来 stop the progression of the disease。 美国也是，欧洲也是，到目前为止，我们觉得对这些病人的一个支持性的治疗还是至为关键。抗病毒治疗我们应该是作为可以用，但是未必会起到非常好的效果。
Again, I'd like to emphasize another point about how to reduce the mortality rate. That is to properly monitor those mild cases, because for some of them, the progression of the disease could be very fast. So one thing to take note in treating and monitoring the mild cases is to make sure that the patients get sufficient nutrition. And secondly, you need to pay attention to the changes in some indicators for the progression of the disease. For example, the increase in indicators like D-dimers and LDH could indicate a worsening of the condition and could lead to mortality. So make sure that the patients get enough and proper nutrition. That is why I always emphasize the importance of support therapy more than the antiviral therapy, which I'd like to also say a few words about. So according to the data that we have so far, none of the antiviral therapies that we have tried has been proved truly effective by the published data so far, including some of the studies done by our French colleagues on hydroxychloroquine and also some RCT studies done by our Chinese colleagues. None of them has proved the effectiveness of hydroxychloroquine in fighting this virus, COVID-19. It has shown some effect in controlling the inflammation. In other words, it has some anti-inflammatory effect, but its effectiveness in terms of stopping the progression of the infection is yet to be approved. So that is why I would like to emphasize the importance of carrying out proper support treatment. I think it is critical to stop the progression of the disease for some mild cases. Of course, you can use some antiviral treatment or therapies, but its effectiveness is yet to be proved.